Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to be showing you how to connect to H2 database using IntelliJ IDEA's database client. For testing, we need a sample project and of course IntelliJ IDEA. I assume that you already have IntelliJ IDEA. Let's go to the IntelliJ IDEA. I also hope you are familiar a little bit with IntelliJ, but it doesn't matter if you are not, I will show all the details. I use the ultimate version of the IntelliJ. For the Ultimate Edition, by default database tools plugin already installed. You don't need to do more. But for Community Edition, you must download it. I will show you how to do this. Go to the toolbar and click the settings. If you can't see this toolbar, go to the view and activate the toolbar. As you see, it's gone. Go to the view and activate the toolbar. Another way. Go to the file and click the setting. It's the same. And type the plugin name. Database. And database and tools. You must download this plugin and restart your IDE. Okay. Let's talk about our project. Our project is a sample Spring Boot application. I will push on GitHub. You can use this project, and it's our application main class, and also I have loader. I load some sample data, image and employee. When we start our project, this data will be loaded on the databases, and go to the properties. In here you can change your properties and change the DB name or other properties. Let's start it. As you see, image and employee row inserted. Now let's start to configure H2 database client. Go to here and click the data source and go to the H2. In here, choose the embedded mode and go to your DB file path. I will just copy and paste our file path. Okay, and as you see, driver already installed. If it's not installed, you need to install this and select the auto synchronize and just test connection. Put the username in properties, and as you see, successful. Apply and okay. Okay, now we see the databases. Okay, but we can't see our tables. Let's go to the settings again. We can't see our schemas. Go to the schema and select all or only our schema. I already used this schema. By default, it's public. Click the apply and click OK. Now we see our tables. Okay, just click here, go to the console and test console also. As you see, it works. I want to point out something. In here, you must go to here and give these properties. Auto server mode should be true, otherwise it will fail and only one connection opened. I will show you. Apply. Okay, I will close all. Close here. Delete the database. Disconnect from here. Delete the old files. stop it. Let's try again. Let's go to the console again and run this. As you see, it fails. Let's look at the error. Yes, the server mode call another connection. Let's change it and retry. It is most important part. If you don't use this init, you may use the default schema, but I don't want to use default schema, I change it. Go to the configuration and add this. Apply, okay, and restart. Let's go to the console again and run the query. Change the query image. Now, as you see, it works. That is all about configuration. Thank you for watching.